Hi all, spent most of today doing electrical calculations for college. So I got suitably bored of that now, pretty much finished, so I thought I'd come out here and do a bit on the ATCO mower. A few little jobs I want to do before I forget. The first of which, I think the fuel line is blocked, because if I take the top off here, you'll see that when I turn the fuel tap on, no fuel comes through. Now there's plenty of fuel in the tank. So turn the tap on. Nothing coming through. Doesn't seem to matter what you do. There's definitely nothing in there. And you can blow down the hole in the top of the tank, so you're pressurizing it. But that doesn't feed anything through, so I suspect it's very well blocked up. In case you're wondering, that's not an enamel float chamber. It's quite different. It's a genuine sen spray thing. Sen spray float chamber, sen spray carburetor. One of the other things I've got to do, I want to take a look at the clutch. I'm not sure that's engaging quite right. Just put the other light on for you. I believe that's engaged at the moment, but I believe it's not quite enough. I had this lever off course yesterday, so I don't think it was engaging quite right. It's not aligned properly, I think. So I've got to look at that. I've got, you can just see that plate there, which is designed, I think, to scrape mud and grass off the roller. You see the one on this side better, that bit. That is a few millimeters clearance, whereas that one is rubbing, which is a bit annoying, especially when trying to move it without the engine running. The other job, which I can't do tonight, I need a new one of those because the throttle cable's busted. Of course, I went to start the thing yesterday, put the throttle on, touch the throttle, and it snapped, or the little thing on the end came off. So I've crimped a bit of pipe on the end, which is just enough to hold it for that test run, so I can get the throttle open, but it won't close down fully. So really I need a new set of cables, but that means having to get a new one of those, because you can't take it apart. I've tried and you can't do it. You need that. And then you can hook them on to the... It's difficult to describe. There's a couple of little lugs they clip onto, and the whole thing is rotational. So it's quite a clever little carburetor, but that's what needs doing. I've also been offered a new exhaust downpipe, so hopefully that's the right one. Okay, well I just wanted to show you a few close-ups of the carburetor. First interesting feature is the mixture control in the mouth of the carburetor. At the moment that's set to fully rich, but if I want to make it leaner, can do that. There's various settings there, so next time I run it I'll try and make it a bit leaner, see if it runs better. Yes, anyway, I managed to sort the fuel issue. Took the fuel line off, but that was clear. Just the tap that was blocked, so I poked a bit of wire through that. Plenty of petrol coming through now, so that's really good. You can get to the jet on these carburetors by removing the set screw there. So you can poke a very fine bit of wire through that or blow it through. Blowing it through the airline is preferable. So I'll just show you what I was saying about the throttle arrangement. I'll take one side off and show you in there.
Okay, well, quite how well you can see this, I don't know, but it's the best I can do, I'm afraid. If I just work the throttle, you'll see which the throttle control is. As you can see, I'm not getting the full movement. It should actually return to about there. That's a bit further round. So that there is the throttle, and that there is the mixture control or choke. That's working exactly as it should. So you see, I can set the throttle to a fixed amount and then let it run, but that's not great. So I either need to get another Senspray genuine throttle cable and lever. I need the whole unit. Or I might be able to substitute another Villiers throttle cable, mount another lever on the handlebars. Won't look right, but I'm not too worried about that. Anyway, so that's just so you can see inside. That's the spindle, and you've got a proper bearing in each side. And the cover presses on like that. Very high quality carburetors, and were fitted to a lot of cycle cars and motorbikes at the time.
Okay, well next I want to make a decompressor lever. So I've already got one here. That's a decompressor. And if you saw my video yesterday of my attempts at starting this, you'll notice that before I was cranking it, I pressed this in, decompress it, and then recompress just before I wanted it to start. Well, there's a hole in there, and you may have noticed a bit of wire going from there to there. Well, that was broken, of course. What this should be, a bit of wire going to a lever which bolts onto there. So that way you could put your left hand round the back there while you were cranking with the right. You weren't reaching through around the spark plug, the fan, whatever. So I'm going to make another one of those.
Okay, well you can see the decompressor I've made, or decompressor lever. What I've done, made up a little handle there, little lever. Can go any way up, actually. Seems to work quite effective, and I've tested it out, works nicely. Just made out of a strip of copper and put a bit of copper wire in between. The only force that's on it is when it's pulling it open, so no need for it to be strong. So I'll just crank the engine over and show you how it works.
Crank it, and once up to speed, let go of the lever. And of course it would start if there was petrol in it.
So there you go, that should make starting it a little bit easier.
Now when I was driving the machine around yesterday, I rather got the feeling that the drive wasn't all it could be. The clutch was slipping. And yeah, it was. I just put it into gear, cranked it over, and that middle roller, which is the driven one at the moment, that was not turning when it's up against the workshop wall, or the bench there. So what I've done is adjusted it so I can crank it over, and the roller's spinning on the floor there, so it's got a really direct drive now. So that's clutched out, that's clutched in, and I can feel from the lever, because it's quite loose, that it's the clutch is taking the load fully. So that's good. So what you do to adjust it, you loosen those two nuts there and you wind that one out just a little. Wind it out and then find the point where it slips. Then wind it back in again, adjust it that way. That way you can get a better sort of feel for it. And you wind that in until when it's clutched out, it's only just clutched out, but the clutch is not touching. The plates are not touching. This is a cone clutch, by the way. So I'll just show you. So it's clutched out at the moment. Decompress the engine, then I can turn it over. Right, so there we go, clutched out. Now clutch in. So there you go, works nicely now. Well, there we go, that's all I'm going to do for tonight, I think. So, what we've done tonight, fitted a decompressor lever over there, which is where it should have been, but was missing. We've adjusted the clutch correctly, and I've just locked off the rollers so that we've got drive all the way across. That's what you need to do for a bumpy lawn like we've got here. So as a mower, once I get that exhaust done, that will make it quiet. That will be quite usable then. Assuming it's starting easily now. I haven't tried to start it again. But should be alright, I think. Other thing I want to do, it has a tow hitch on the back. There. I've got a little ride-on seat that I knocked up for the other mower, and that'll go on there quite nicely, so I can ride around behind it. But I want to get a proper ATCO one. Then if I do take it out to any rallies, I can ride round the ring on it. This would be quite a good one to take in the arena. Quite early machines, quite interesting. As for other projects, got the Amanco head here still. Just waiting on some new cylinder head studs I ordered, which are 7/16 Whitworth, which is interchangeable with the American size that they are. So that's fine, we'll be able to fit those. What else? Yep, got all the governor bits to do still of that engine, but that's not too bad. I've got the cream separator down there to do. I've now got some timber, which is stored up here. And another bit over there somewhere, which I'm going to use to make the frame. That gearbox there, I'm not going to use that. Basically because I can't get the crank bit off the side of it. So I might use that to make a mechanical hacksaw. So, yeah, got quite a lot to do. Anyway, it is, of course, New Year's Eve, so I hope everybody had a good Christmas. I certainly enjoyed it, and I hope you all did too. And I wish you all a very happy 2012. And to those of you that rally engines and equipment, like this old mower, you know, I wish you all an enjoyable and safe 2012 rally season. I'm certainly looking forward to it, the rally starting. I can't wait. It's been too long since I did one. So hopefully have the Amanco and perhaps the WX11 there. Perhaps have those out in February. Anyway, I hope you enjoyed the video. And yeah, I wish you all a very happy new year.